Hello guys, my name is Sergio. Just wanted to show you something that took me a long time to figure out without having a custom funnel. So I'm just launching again my VSL funnel for our new product, and I had an issue. The issue was so people come to my landing page here. How can I pre-fill my Calendly form with people's information that they put on this step here? And how can I pre-fill my application form, the first name, last name, and the email, again with this information here? So I used my skills and I did some script, which I'm happy to show you. So now I'm just gonna use my real information. So I want this information to be auto pre-filled on my Calendly page and questionnaire. So I continue, I come here, so people will watch the video or they will click this button here and they will be coming to book a slot on my appointment over here. So I select the slot, I continue. So you see, it's autocomplete. And now I put my phone number, just a demo phone number, that's the real one. I schedule a call. And now what will happen here, you will see here again that the information is pre-filled for the full name and email. And this is so much better because I don't want people to type in again the same information. So they just need to complete these questions and they have a call with me and my team. So how I did this, just to show you, to share the value with the community here. So you need to go to the first page where is your pop-up from the ClickFunnels. I also have an integration with ActiveCampaign. So what you have to do, you need to come to settings and go to tracking code and put this code on your footer. So actually this code you can ignore, is from ActiveCampaign. So you just need to add this code here, which I'm happy to share. So basically I'm detecting the button when it gets submitted, and then I get the values from the fields for the name and the email. So that's how we do it, and I store it on the local storage. So the browser has local storage. All browsers, they have local storage. I store it there and I can use it on any other page I wish to. So this is the first thing you do. Then I go back. So I want to use this information on my calendar page. So on my calendar page, I come here, I edit the page. So this is my script from Calendly. Nothing changes here. And this is my custom script, which I'm gonna read the values and insert them to the Calendly. So here again, I read the name and the email from the local storage over here. And then I have looked up the Calendly documentation and found out this snippet of code. So I pass this to the Calendly. So I just need to put the URL of my Calendly here. So I pass the details inside Calendly. Now, how do I send from here the Calendly, from Calendly to the application page? Very simple. Here, I'm not gonna read the values from the local storage because maybe the user has changed his values there. So what you need to do is you need to go to your Calendly and you need to enable one simple setting. So I come here on the edit page. On the confirmation page, you set your redirect URL and you need to click this pass event details to your redirect page. So you can read from here. You see all the information is on the URL. So I just read the information from the URL. So I come here to this page. Where is my, so over here, custom JavaScript, this is my code from active campaign. So the code from active campaign actually is this one. And I add this code here. So I prefill over here, I grab the parameters from the URL, I identify them, and I prefill the name over here. So pretty simple. I spent some time to do it, but I have the right background. But if you want to do it, you can just go through this video, pause the video, copy the code. I'm happy to give out the code as well. And that's how I do it, guys. So hope this helps to improve your funnel. Thank you so much.